Engineers and operators at CH2M Hill Plateau Remediation Company have developed new software that is improving operations of pump and treats significantly. With the simple click of a mouse, a pump and treat is up and running.
This is a lot about the workforce.
Phil Sheely, pump and treat operations manager, says operators and engineers got together, thought of this idea, and made it happen.
It's really nice to see a concept go from, you know, just an idea that seemed pretty far-fetched to something that's become easily implementable.
This automatic start is making a significant impact. In the past, operators used a complex system to start up pump and treats. It required turning on different systems of wells, transfer pumps, and injection wells. It was time-consuming, and the system had to be in sync in order for the plant to start up properly. Now the new software does it all.
Amazing addition to a pretty robust program.
The new change allows the systems to be easily shut down and restarted, making maintenance outages more efficient and less time-consuming. Operators also can recover sooner when they have problems with the plant. The sooner pump and treats are fired up, the quicker they can get to treating contaminated groundwater. This is only one of many pump and treat efficiencies Sheely's team has come up with. He is proud his team is highly skilled and dedicated to protecting the Columbia River.
This is one of many changes that the pump and treats have gone through to make them more robust, run more efficiently, run better, easily maintainable. It's a tribute to the whole team.
Currently, there are 5 pump and treats along the Columbia River. 4 of them have the new software, and the final pump and treat will be getting it soon.